Rafal Sonik. I am a Polish quad rider. I race for 18 years. It's my sixth Qatar rally in career. I was three times a winner of this rally and two times second. So it's the rally I know.
This is my third time that I have the opportunity to be racing here, and it's fun. It's always difficult. Every year is really difficult, the navigation and everything, but it's really fun to be here one more time.
Very happy to be here to do my first World Championship Rally Cross Country. And I hope this weekend is going to be very successful for all the races.
For the bikes, it will be the second event of the year, so we don't have as much experience on the riders. But usually, the bikes competition is decided by seconds only. So I'm sure this will be a great event.
We are very excited about this race. It's going to be a difficult race. I would like just to take a moment to thank everyone who has been involved in organizing this rally.
The level of the riders is higher, so I expect an intense race. I hope be ready to be in these top guys again, so let's see.
So now I'm really happy to be here. The team was really good in Abu Dhabi. We had a tough fight, as we always do there, and I'm feeling good on the bike, and yeah, really happy to start this race.
The winner of the Abu Dhabi Desert Challenge this year, Sunderland, for the Red Bull KTM Rally Factory Team.
Yeah, in the end, the expectation grows. You know, every time you win, the next race you arrive to, the expectation's there. But I think as long as you want it more than you feel pressure, then it's okay. And the team are really great with that stuff. They know how the race works, and you know, they know how much we want to win ourselves, and I know how much they want to win. So it's kind of we just come here and do our best, and yeah, hopefully that's enough.
The super special stage is two things in one. It's first of all, it's used to determine the starting order for the real rally. But it's also a promotional opportunity, because in a desert event, the people, it's not easy to follow a rally like this. So this, we are now very close to the city, and the people can watch the cars and the bikes in the real action.
I'm more excited about seeing the professionals perform in the special stage. It is like technical, and it is for them more than it is for me. For me, it is the long sections where I'm challenging myself, and not the special stage where I'm challenging the watch.
Motocross bike have to be work on average speed around 50-60, and our bike have to work at the average speed at about 110-120.
The whole bike's pretty different. The weight, obviously there's a lot more weight when you're carrying all the navigation stuff, the extra fuel, the bigger tanks. But around a motocross track, as long as it's not too heavy and deep sand and rough, like on a normal motocross track, you're normally kind of 4 to 5 seconds a lap slower. So it's not so huge, the difference.
The base for our quad is a factory produced quad. We just take it completely apart after buying just in a shop. Then we put together parts which we have selected and tested over the years, so that on the end of the day the quad is still reliable, but it's completely remodeled.
Hello,
Yeah, it was good. It was nice. A little bit different with the water holes and things. For me, I think I took a little bit too much care with the road book for the dangers and things.
If one of the toughest rally in the calendar, if not the toughest rally in the calendar. Last year I crashed out here in day four with concussion and broken knee. So my expectation this year to take it easy and not do the same mistake as last year.
Last year I finished five, but I was far from the leader, so the goal is to be more close. Why not to win a stage also?
I expect to be ready to fight for the victory on this race. In the past I do it. Every year I stay in the fight for the victory. This year I think we will have a nice race in front because we are here, I think, 7 or 8 riders with the speed to be on this group. Two little horns and they're giving me a little
bit. She's a fan. For this rally, I expect really difficult navigation. Normally it's really rough and hard days because with all the stones and this difficult navigation, you have to be always focused, especially with the bike, because if you miss like one stone, can be really bad for you.
We are just starting the World Cup, so it's important to be in front, but also it's important to think about all the season. Sure, this race is really important for the overall standing. I will try to do a clean race and to do a good navigation and have a good rhythm during all the race.
We always know we're in for a tough time here in Qatar, you know, just the nature of the terrain and a lot of navigation. The terrain's really hard to read with a lot of tracks minus visible and many, many junctions and forks in the road.
I expect navigation to be extremely challenging as every year. This time it seems as well that we will have extremely high temperatures. The temperatures we are facing here are usually around 40 degrees. Hopefully there will be some wind. Part of the Qatar desert is extremely challenging. It's rocky, it's stony.
It's 150k was quite okay. Then at kilometer 180 I have a big mistake and I missed a piste and I almost crashed, and from this point I have not so good rhythm anymore and I get sometimes lost. It was really hard for me after to find a good pace, and it feels really long the last part, and I was not so fast.
A good state for me. I had a problem at the start with the fuel injection. I stopped it and then I fixed the bike and I could continue. So Then I think I did a good navigation, so I arrived good.
4 hours pushing out there, and we have pretty hot temperatures and a lot of navigation and a lot of stones here, so you have to be really focused. But it went well. The bike was working really good, and I felt confident with the navigation, and I kept pushing all day, and yeah, really happy. So it was a good result, but we have 3 long days to come.
It was very hard today. We had a lot of parts with hard pack, 150 kilometers to hard pack. Then the last 100, we have some dunes.
Rocks hard, sand soft, hot, wind, camelback boiling. So when you drink, you just drink like a hot soup.
For me, it's important to be relaxed, to have a clear vision of what I want to do during the day.
Sometimes before we start, we are really confident.
Trying to visualize what you're going to be doing kind of in that zone, so when you start you're already there in your mind.
2-3 minutes before start is so much butterflies. Is honestly sometimes I want to trade the place with the guy who give me the countdown, you know, change life. But once he say go, I want to be the rider.
Try to connect myself with the desert and what I should do or I want to do during the day.
And you know, with the road book, with the navigation, looking at the track, looking out for the dangers. Take my hand and leave it all to luck. They'll never catch us if they don't look back. Can I promise you the fun won't stop
and we can do it all. You have to keep it cool, to think properly, not to make mistakes, which can be very costly, especially in Qatar and in navigation through this very, very difficult desert.
The only thing about to push, you know, is the same feeling that I feel when I see the finish line. I only want to push it until the end. It's my, always my main goal.
It's hard, you know, the bike goes all the time like sideways, and it's difficult to jump, it's moving a lot, so we need to burn a lot of energy to keep the bike straight, and also with the navigation, and now it's more difficult everything.
When we have a crosswind, we obviously have to lean into it, so when we hit the bumps, the bike is already at an angle, so it reacts differently, you know, it comes side to side a lot more, and you have to pay attention.
Sometimes with sandstorm is like a pain on our face, no? The sand shoots us, so also about visibility is quite hard to see, especially when we are on the dunes, because the sand, I think, likes are half a meter. It's really difficult, but it's the same situation for all of us. At the end, I arrive with Sam, so I'm happy right now. I'm second overall, so the bike worked perfectly.
Long and really hard, but I managed not so bad with the navigation, and I'm pretty happy that I can win the stage.
We had a lot of mental work. I catch Alexis Hernandez, and we were going together. I was working with my mental abilities, and he was fast. So he was pushing me to work faster and think faster.
He's a nice person. He's a world championship, a Dakar champion. It's not so easy to get a complete stage with a champion like Rafal. I hope we can be like friends and at the same time competitors.
Absolutely great competitor, and what is the most important, he is not only tough, smart, but he is also very fair.
I got tired with my head because
here. Today was a fun day. It's amazing to be here in Qatar and have stages like today with someone who can teach me a lot of things, you know.
He knows exactly what to do, in which moment not to create dangerous situations. I like this kind of competition a lot.
Matthias was doing a good job opening.
To open the track, of course, in the dunes is much more hard because you see pretty well the line in the sand. But after, when you have like the stony desert, it's not really a help also because you trust more the line or you trust yourself, because in the end, the guy win who make the less mistakes.
With the navigation here is always tricky. I think it's the most difficult navigation in the calendar. I don't know how you can train perfectly for this. I think it's the best is to find your way in the day one and then understand the roadbook, and then I think from there it's a bit, I won't say easier, but better.
Now the season starting in like in end of February, there I train a lot in the mountains in Austria. I go up with the skis, I try to run, try to cycling.
But yeah, obviously with a lot of riding, a lot of physical preparation, bicycle, and also the navigation here for Qatar, we know that it's tough.
So we have the luck with the Husqvarna Rally team to have a training base in Spain for make some roadbook training. So this is really important things for us.
Very difficult, so tricky. Navigation was very, very complicated, but I feel good. My hand worked good.
So after the refuel, I pushed really hard and did some good navigation and yeah, kept everything going in a good way. And no, it was good to get another stage win.
I don't have words to say what I'm feeling about the stage because I was leading until the last 3 kilometers. One electric cable cut it. I lost the first position and Rafal take it again. And I lost.
Extremely difficult stage for me. 120 kilometers before the finish, my A-arm on the front suspension broke off, the front part. I don't know why and I don't know how. I did not feel any heat or something. It was just all of a sudden it broke off. So I have to fix it with the zip ties. I saw Alexis a couple kilometers before the finish. He said his bike is completely broken.
Hace 15 minutos o media hora, a 1000 metros se apagó la moto.
Only Qatari rider in the race. If you want to be first, of course you will feel pressure. But if you want to be finished, you feel enough pressure to make you finish. So that's my goal, to finish and not to be behind the leaders by much.
My start position is 4, so I have a two or three guys fight against me in front, and I have other two or three start behind me. So the target is try to push, and the most important than this is don't make any navigation mistakes.
Everybody say you are crazy, why you are doing this? Because in the end, it's my passion, it's what I love to do.
At this moment, when you ride like 150, 160 on a stony path, you don't think about crashing. But true, I don't like so much to go this fast on a stony path, but if you want to be in front, you have to it.
We know the watch didn't stop, never. So it's important to go fast, but try to don't make mistakes.
You only stay focused on the roadbook to take care of everything, and you have no time for seeing to another thing.
In a stony place, and you're coming obviously really fast, it's very difficult to spot every stone. So you kind of, you know, you just kind of look out for the big ones, if you like, and try and look far enough ahead that you can see a clear route.
Personally, for me, it's something that I love a lot of this sport, the high speed, and I think I get a good connection with myself and the bike. And this is one of the things that I love more of this sport.
You have to be confident in your equipment and in your abilities to adjust the speed to the terrain you are riding over.
Yeah, the first 120 was not so good. I get two times lost and I lost quick 3 minutes to Gonçalves.
Again, another difficult stage like all the others before. I'm second on overall when I catch them, and after I stay right with them, try to arrive without problems, and I'm happy for this.
There's never such thing as an easy stage here in Qatar. You know, there's a lot of stones, a lot of navigation. In a race like here in Qatar, it's so easy to get lost. You know, even though I had 12 minutes or so this morning lead, yeah, you have to be really focused at all times. So yeah, when you get across the line, it's almost like a great feeling of satisfaction, but also relief. So yeah, really happy.
Most of the stage we went together, approximately 90th kilometer. Alexis caught me, and of course I could not get off because it's not enough power, not enough speed difference. Thank you. my sixth Qatar rally. I won fourth and I am very happy.
It was fantastic. It was an amazing rally. The conditions were very tough. These guys are tough guys. You know, they finished the race after 5 days, which is amazing. You know, especially the ones who are riding bikes.
First half of the rally, you think, oh, it's so long. How will I do it? How will I make it? How will I survive it? And then, somewhere in the middle, you think, oh, I would like to do more.
When you're there, you're lost, you're hot, you're hungry, you're thirsty. You hate it, but you always come back for more.
The navigation has been really difficult for everybody. And this is the feature of the Qatar Cross-Country.
It's an amazing race, these four stages. We have a really tough competition by navigation, by physical situation.
It's really hard rally, but really good for training and especially for the navigation.
After the race, after it is all over, you go back to your normal job or life, it feels a bit boring. You cannot live all your life in a rally, but you can do it and go back to your boring life and, you know, you'll have those memories.